Good morning, sister. I am Melroy Saldana. Deacon Ivan has always emphasized the role of women and women religious in church and our society. Not surprising, therefore, that he's invited you to our chat show that's Date with DYC. In our invitation, we want to acknowledge the services offered by our consecrated women in the Archdiocese of Bombay and the entire country. So welcome, sister. Everyone, please give sister a round of applause. So, Sister Beena. So, sister, how do I address you? Is Sister Dr. Beena or Dr. Beena or Sister Beena? What exactly do people address you as? What is your official and what we can address you?
Some people address me as Sister Beena, some as Dr. Beena. You can address as comfortable.
Okay. So, sister, can you tell us something more about yourself and about your congregation?
I'm practicing consultant gynecologist at Holy Family Hospital. I've been there for past 12 years.
Okay.
I joined as a clinical associate in Holy Family Hospital in gynecology department. Later, I was asked by my superiors to work as the medical superintendent for 5 years. So, I worked as a medical superintendent of the hospital for 5 years. Then I thought of developing my clinical practice little more. So, I asked for a break. So, they gave me 6 months break and asked me again to become the deputy director.
Okay.
So, it keeps on changing or evolving.
Okay.
I belong to the congregation of the Ursulines of Mary Immaculate. This is originally an Italian congregation. Our foundress was a very daring woman who started the congregation 371 years ago in Piacenza, Italy. The Indian mission started somewhere around 1934, wherein 5 Italian missionaries came to India and pioneered their work in southern part. That small mission, humble mission, began by our pioneer sisters, gradually grew and expanded to other parts of country, like north, west, and northeast regions. Today, after 86 years of our presence in India, we have more than 100 communities across our country, of which 9 are in Maharashtra.
Nine communities,
including Bandra Holy Family Hospital community.
Okay.
We are 18 sisters in Bandra Holy Family community. Besides Italy and India, we have our presence in UK, Ireland, Brazil, Tanzania, and Kenya. We, your mice, actually witness our love for God through our committed activities in educational field, healthcare, and socio-pastoral apostolate. Our foundress mentioned that we need to be available to the signs of the time according to the need of the church. This allows us to venture into any ministry if it is the need of the church. So here we are, meaningfully engaged in various ministries in schools, hospitals, dispensaries, home for the aged, destitute home, and also in socio-pastoral sector. Recently, we have also begun the family apostolate in certain places in communities.
That's so much of amazing work you are doing, sister, and it is spread across different areas, so that's really commendable. We're all aware about Holy Family being the forefront of the coronavirus epidemic. Tell us about the teething realities, the struggles that you all faced, and also when we were not immunized, also when we were not immunized as per the rest of the world. So tell us the struggles that you faced.
The mission of our hospital is to to provide quality and competent care and to serve the needs of the community, irrespective of caste, creed and economic status. When the first few cases of coronavirus was reported from Mumbai city, some of us in the management committee could foresee what is awaiting us as an impact of this pandemic in India as well as in Mumbai city specifically. So we began our planning and discussion, and we decided that we need to open our facilities to take care of the COVID patients. Basically, we are doing our mission or continuing our mission, that is to be available to the needs of the community. Once we decided, we started planning and preparations. We conducted intense training sessions for all strata of our employees, from doctors, nurses, paramedics, housekeeping staff, and other support service staff. Later, we procured high quality personal protective equipment to ensure the protection and safety of our medical team. We also assigned certain responsibilities to different teams, like to prepare the standard operative procedures, the infection control guidelines, and the treatment protocols. It took almost 1 month for us to operationalize the isolation ward because there were a lot of specifications we had to adhere to comply with the government regulations. Okay. Once we got ready, we first tried a standalone center in collaboration with BMC at Khar.
Okay.
After that, we started admitting patients in the hospital.
Okay.
But as the number of cases were increasing, we increased and expanded our bed strength. So today we have about 125 beds for COVID care, of which 28 are the bed facility in the critical care.
Okay.
With ventilators.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have also non-COVID patients. So we have kept 50% for COVID care and 50% for non-COVID care.
So are there challenges that you'll face with non-COVID, COVID, and what if the beds are full in terms of COVID, and how do you all treat them and then probably help them to some other facilities?
Yes, we actually stabilize them, and if there are no beds, then we refer them to other facilities, other neighboring hospitals.
So that's great. At least you all are stabilizing them and helping them, at least the journey to the other hospital, and then that's great. Sister, we only imagine the perks in the medical fraternity most of the times. But in the last few months, we have, I think, got a reality check in our minds. These moments we've heard preachers highlighting the medical personnel as the saints next door. That's even Pope Francis in his writing, Gaudate et Exultate, which is on holiness. I think it's easy for us to just make an expression, but ground reality is really different, and it's tough and it's painful. Can you share some of these moments with us?
I think all of us across the world, people live in a very, very difficult time now. And especially in healthcare sector, there is a lot of uncertainty.
Okay.
This new disease has caused a lot of fear in us. We had administrative hurdles, we have operational challenges, clinical dilemmas, and as well as financial constraints. Especially when we deal with this disease associated with a lot of fear and stigma. So the patients are fear-stricken. The relatives are very anxious. So it takes a lot of time and effort to manage them. Besides that, it's a very difficult experience to wear the personal protective equipment, the N95 mask, the protective goggles, and the face shield. We feel very suffocated inside once we wear it.
Mm.
And the duration, we are not able to eat or drink or even go to washroom. So 6 hours or more, we have to stay
6 hours without going to the washroom.
Yes, we need to do that. So it is very difficult. Besides this, when we wear the goggles, there's a lot of fogging happening.
Huh.
So there is blurring of vision. We are not able to see. And even while we speak, there's a lot of difficulty in speaking. We need to speak loudly to communicate to the patients and the other persons in the medical team. So we find it very difficult to manage once we wear that. And besides that, we have to manage the critical patients.
Okay.
And The personal protective equipment, once in a while in Mumbai weather, it's very hot very and hot. Humid. So we get drenched in sweat within hours of wearing it. And it is very difficult to move around when we are drenched in sweat.
Sister, any funny incident that has happened that you all have been locked in the PPE kits for 6 hours and somebody wanted to go to the loo and couldn't take out any of these funny incidents have happened?
See, I have read from China incident in Wuhan. They were wearing pampers. The doctors and nurses were wearing pampers because they did not have time. And their duration of duty hours were more. But here, so far, we have managed. We are able to manage. I do not know what is awaiting us.
So, but sister, from March, when the entire scare that spread across the country, and I think when the COVID cases were just rising, and to when lockdown was implemented, to the situation right now where I think we are in unlock 4. So has there been a drastic change? Has the number of patients reduced, or there are that many number of people getting infected on the same lines, or is there some sort of relief measure that we've got?
So far we have not seen a decline in number of patients. The ICU beds are full and we get frantic calls for beds even middle of the night. So I cannot say that the cases are declined.
But sister, in the outside everywhere, people are just roaming as though there's nothing happened. The traffic has come back to normal. So do you think that life has come back to normal, or that is happening because currently the economy of the country is affected?
Maybe the things are not that people got used to this kind of the fear is slowly melting away. So they are taking it too casually, I think. And we may have a second wave, which we will not be able to manage.
So have we hit the peak till now, or we have not hit the peak?
I'm not able to say that.
So you're not able to say that. Yeah. So sister, from your experiences, there have been a lot of hard times, I must say. And y'all, are there some more difficulties that you'll face?
Yes, we were also had this, many of our caregivers, the doctors, nurses, and other employees, they contracted the illness. Huh. It's a risky involvement, or I can say a risky job when we are taking care of such highly infectious disease. So once many of them got infected and got admitted in the hospital, so I was very much worried about and concerned about their well-being. As well as that fear was there, and that was disturbing me, whether I'm going to get the disease. So that was a real disturbing time for me. And when the nurses, many of them are from South India, they got this infection and their parents started calling us and troubling us. So that was another time for us to, we spent a lot of time to convince them and to cool them down, reassuring them. And it was such a stressful moment for all of us. In the hospital, especially the top management, to motivate the doctors, nurses and other employees to keep on working. And it is not 1 or 2 months. Now we have already passed six months. And so it's becoming, the fatigue is going high, the stress level is going high for all the employees.
So is there like a silver lining because of this entire pandemic? Can you elaborate something about it?
Yes, in all these difficulties, we also experienced a lot of joy, hope and fulfillment. We really experienced the divine intervention in these difficult times in our midst. Especially, so far we have treated around 1,200 patients, COVID patients. And each recovery is a rewarding moment for the entire medical team. It really lifts our spirit to see the patient getting all right and walking out of our hospital. I can vividly remember one incident. A 71-year-old man came to our emergency with fever and breathlessness. On examination, he was in altered sensorium and he did not have good oxygen saturation. His saturation level was just 58%.
Okay.
So we had to resuscitate him, stabilize him and shift him to the ICU. He was on ventilator for a long time, almost 2 weeks. After recovery, he was discharged. One day he came to my office with folded hands and with tear in his eyes to thank me for saving his life.
Okay.
That was really a very, very touching moment in my life. And I really feel that the joy of saving a life is much more than any other joys in life.
And you all have been doing this for now so many years, that saving people's life, and that's such a beautiful and heartwarming story. You bring such great hope to humanity, sister. And no wonder Mary Magdalene was the first woman that Jesus chose after his resurrection to be the first person to see him. Sister Beena, why not share us something about your vocation story? I think a lot of people watching this right now have this question, that how did you decide to be a religious, and were there any boys who say, Sister Beena, tumhare Beena, hame now rega any Jina, and were there some of these vocation stories? Please tell us. This is what everyone is interested in.
To become a sister was my childhood desire. And being brought up in a traditional Catholic family, I had nurtured this desire all through. Having said this, I had my own difficulties to make up my mind. My relatives and my friends did not wanted me to become a
Why?
Sister. Because I was a topper in my class.
Oh.
And I was good at sports.
Really?
So they were trying to persuade me to have a good career in my life.
They wanted you to be a part of Indian Olympics team.
I'm not so sure. But then I was confused. There was this desire. At the same time, they are persuading me. So during those days, I thought, okay, I'll become a lawyer and I will have my own family, and I'll forget about this desire of becoming a sister. Then I actually had this fear whether I'll be live up to my call as a sister. So with all this confusion, one day I met a priest. He was the principal of my school.
Okay.
His guidance gave me a little bit of clarity on how to choose a life state. And that was the time I also spoke about this to my parents. And I decided that I will leave aside all the other options and I will join the convent.
Okay.
But even after joining convents, the initial years I was struggling whether I should go back, because I was very good at
sports
and studies.
Studies.
So I should go back and study and pursue some good career in life. And during the formation years, I somehow discerned my vocation as a sister. And I should say that as a teenager, I had my own distractions, some secret attractions. And also, there were times I got carried away with things. But this thought of becoming a sister was actually coming and resurfacing in my mind every now and then. Also, I wanted always to remain focused in my studies.
Okay.
So that was another thing. So I made up my mind and I discerned my vocation during the formation years. And once I became the sister, my superiors gave me ample opportunities to grow in whichever field as per my aptitude and passion. During the formation years, I was also given exposure to different ministries, like schools, hospitals, and social work sector. Today, after so many years, the same relatives and friends feel that I'm a blessing and they take so much pride in me. And they tell me that I have done the right decision as a young girl to join the convent. And I too feel a kind of fulfillment in my life. And I feel that joy that I'm there, available to the needs of the church, and completely and totally available to the service of humanity.
So what was the congregation that you've joined? Was there any thought behind it, or did you go for a vocation course, or did you find out about other congregations and then decide to join this particular congregation?
No, my aunt was a sister in this congregation.
Okay.
So she used to, actually in a way, she used to persuade me, if you like to join, you can join the congregation. So that was...
Tell you good stories about the congregation.
Congregation. Yeah.
Yeah.
But then at the same time, I used to hear the other side of the life, in religious life.
Okay.
And my sisters and few cousins also had joined the congregation. So I was inspired to join this congregation.
Oh, that's great. Thank you so much, Sister Beena. This totally has been a holy family talk to our human family. And sister, before we conclude, we want to take you to this selfie booth that we've created. And we want to introduce you to Jesus, who's the school Jesus in blue jeans. And sister, let's go to the selfie booth. So sister, welcome you to our selfie booth. This is Jesus in blue jeans. And a selfie with our guest, our dost, and this is your host. Sister, can you, can we, are you ready to take a selfie?
Yes.
Here, come here, come. Okay. Sister. Sister, in 3, 2, 1. Smile, sister. Thank you, sister, for your time. We have a small token of appreciation. Sister, this is a mug for you. This is with Jesus imprinted. This is a small token.
Thank you.
And we have a big token of appreciation that we've got for you. This is we've got this on rent from Coffee with Karan. And we have to give it back, so I'll take it back from my sister.
I'm joking, sister.
Sister, thank you for your time. And any advice do you want to give for young people?
I think today's young people have a lot of options. And what they need is just to listen to their inner voice and discern their plan and purpose for God.
Thank you, sister. This is your gift. And we hope that you keep coming back and we hope you had a good time.
Thank you. Thank you, Melroy. It was really nice.
Thank you, sister. So, ladies and gentlemen, today at Live Nights with DYC, we have this young gentleman by the name of Jerry, who Deacon Ivan has invited us among summits. So, Jerry, tell us, what do you do?
We call it somewhat kind of modern magic.
Okay.
So, it's basically magic, mentalism and an illusion mixture.
So, you're a magician?
I'm a magician.
So, when did you get this whole likeness towards magic?
Since the childhood, I wanted to do something totally different. So, totally different. I tried. Well, I used to do singing before.
Okay.
But I was not so impressed with the stuff like singing and all.
Okay.
So, I want to do something totally different and magic. Magic is something which you get not many people involved in it.
Okay. But a lot of people get involved. So, you wanted to do something in talent, and when is the first time, at what age and how many years ago that magic is something that I want to be?
I still remember I was in college and
That is last year?
No.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, so.
When I was at the age of 16. So
That is last year?
No, not
oh,
last
sorry.
Year.
You have a lot of time. Okay.
I'm 24 now, so that's okay. So I was in college. I was at the age of 16. I saw a guy performing magic with the cards and all.
Okay.
And I was damn impressed with his skills. And I was like, no, I want to learn this at any cost. So I went behind him. I used to follow him till the bus stop, and I used to please him that if you can please teach me magic. Oh. And he was like, no, it's not possible. Not everyone can do magic.
Okay.
I still remember it took me a couple of weeks to convince him that I want to do magic. And then he gave me a card and he told me that you can go to this place and learn magic.
Okay. So that's when you learned magic. Yeah. Even when I was small, I was quite impressed by this guy who removed kabutar from one box. And even I started running behind the kabutar and they said, kabutar ja ja. After that, my magic dreams was just shattered.
Yeah.
But so what is the first trick that you've done? I'm damn impressed. Thank you.
The first magic, right? The first magic which I did was taking out a cloth from a thin air and disappearing it again. That was the first magic I did.
Can you disappear coronavirus right now? Because everyone is.
I would be so glad that if I.
You could do it. No, because everyone is now irritated. They want to come out from their houses.
I really don't know if they exist also or not.
Coronavirus or human beings?
Coronavirus.
Coronavirus. Okay. Theek hai. So, when did you decide? So, at the age of 16, you said, I want to learn magic. And your first magic trick was removing a cloth out of thin air and then disappearing it.
Yeah.
When was the first time you said, like, this is giving me money and this is what I want to do as a career? And man, forget singing and dancing. I want to be an illusionist. Is that what they call it?
Illusionist, mentalist.
Mentalist and as well as magician.
Magician, yeah.
So, when did you say that this is what I want to do?
I think it was the time when. If I really say it and
say it, go for it. No.
So it was the time when I got an offer from MTV from you.
Okay. Oh, from me only.
My God. So I was actually I wanted to do it.
Okay.
But I didn't get a catch.
Okay.
So you were the person who gave me the catch and you gave me the fame from MTV Nescafe.
Okay.
So Wall of Fame, I remember that. Yeah. And at that time it was like, yes, I can do something. So,
oh, great man. I didn't even know that. I genuinely didn't know this, that I've touched people. Arre yaar, tu wo time pe thoda paisa de deta hai mere ko aaj abhi thoda khana bhi na. But thank great man. But I've seen his magic and I know that He does some amazing tricks. Can you show us some tricks right now? So are you all excited to see some tricks?
If you tell it tricks, no, I'm not gonna show. But if you tell me that yes, I'm gonna show some magic. Yeah, I will.
So show me some magic. Whatever you want to call it, I'll call it magic. Everything so that you do, I'm going to call it
You
magic.
Have seen me doing magic with cards, coins and many stuff.
I've seen you do magic with cards, coins. I've also seen him do magic with a nut and a bolt.
Nut and a bolt,
I've also seen him do magic with people. He's disappeared some people that I don't like also and he's never bought them back. I hope they're not, they don't want to
today,
come back.
Today, you have never seen me doing magic with a mobile phone or a digital magic. So what in case if today I show you some digital magic, how impressive
can you, it can you get me some old deleted messages on WhatsApp back because my ex-girlfriend sent me a message and she deleted it. You bring that back?
There is another app. So why do you use magic for
that? Okay, okay. What magic are you going to show
me? If you don't mind, right, if I can just use your mobile.
Let me see, balance is there. Is there balance?
Okay. And you use Instagram, right?
Instagram. Yeah.
So we'll go in the Instagram and I won't show you what I'm going to do is, right? I'm going to search one name into Instagram.
This is scary. Don't search Sunny Leone, okay? I already follow her.
Okay. And I'm going to lock it. So it's locked. So it has a password, right?
Yeah.
I don't know the password.
No.
So I cannot touch the phone anymore.
Okay.
And I'm going to keep the phone over here. So there is no practical or possible way I can reach the phone and touch it.
Yeah. For all those who are seeing my phone, yes, I need a new phone. Please donate. Link in the bio. Please Google pay me the money. Okay.
So it is not practically possible. I can do any goofy things with your phone.
Nothing.
Okay. So, but I didn't mention to you that I do write up notes each and every day.
Okay.
So, I have notes with 100 greatest movies of all the time, 100 greatest Bollywood or Hollywood
actors. This is
scary,
man. This is scary, okay.
And 52 cards and all. So, today what we are going to do is that we are going to go with the actors list.
Okay.
So there are many lists in the notes. So, I would be specified about it that we are going to go with the actors list.
Okay.
And I have not paid you for it. So, there is no reason that you will lie to it.
I'm waiting for somebody paying me. Nobody's paying.
So, basically, many of the people over here know how the iPhone thing works, right? So there is no practical or possible way that I'm gonna goof up with the iPhone thing also. This is the normal iPhone you can see over here.
See, for all those who are seeing, that's an iPhone. This is a Hunar phone. Please Google pay me money to buy a new phone.
Okay, so we are gonna choose in the list of 1 to 100. So what in case if I ask you to choose any one number between 1 to 100, which number would you like?
69.
Yeah, that's a 69. Great number. So if you really want to change, you can change it.
No, I don't want to change.
Okay, so you can see I have a normal phone over here and you chose a number 69, which is your random choice.
Yeah.
And we have a notes over here. Okay. So if you don't mind, if you can just click on the notes for me.
Where is notes?
The notes over here.
Notes.
Again, you can see, I have, as I told you, commonly selected cards, top 100 greatest movies of all time, breviages, celebrities, groceries, family gift ideas, that is personal.
Okay.
So that is totally different. So,
girlfriend ideas? No, not
that. Gift ideas. Okay, so we are going to go with the celebrities list. So you chose a number 69. What in case if you can touch it?
No, don't worry. I'll touch it later.
So what in case if you don't wanted to choose a number 69, which number would you like to prefer to choose?
I would like to choose number 82.
82? Right, so you chose a number 69 here. Now you are changing to 82. It's the last chance I am giving you. If you want, you can change the number. Otherwise, you cannot.
No, 82 is the number. That
82 is the number you want to be with. So now you chose a number 82. Okay. Although you chose a number 69, then you changed it.
Yeah.
And I told you that you cannot change it further.
Yeah.
So what in case if we'll go on the notes, if you don't mind clicking on the notes over here.
I'll click. This is the notes I clicked.
Okay, so you can see that we have commonly selected cards, top 100 greatest movies of all time, breviages, celebrities, groceries, family idea gifts, that's all personal.
Top 10 girlfriends,
so that's great.
Sorry, girlfriend ideas.
I would have glad to see that as well. Yeah. But we chose a list celebrities for today, right?
Okay.
And you chose a number 82. Just imagine if you would have chosen a number 69, what it would be?
69.
It was Bruno Mars.
Bruno Mars.
Right, but you changed it to a number
82.
82. Just imagine if we go to the number 82, what is it?
Michael Jackson.
Now that is totally random and totally different, right? So that is not practically possible that it is a totally random choice. Totally random choice,
yeah,
right? You chose a number, you changed it.
I'm right.
But what in case if I tell you that the only name which I searched on Instagram, your Instagram, is Michael Jackson, how amazing it would be.
I don't know how that happened.
Just check it out. Just open the phone. Check it out what it says.
There is Michael Jackson.
Just show it to the camera, sir.
There's Michael Jackson. This is the name. How did you do that?
So that is how we can play with your mind. We can ask you to change the number. So if you would have chosen 69, obviously it would be wrong. So that's the reason I actually forced you to choose a number 82.
Okay.
So that is how it goes.
Okay. Come on, everyone, please give him a round of applause. That's so good. Can you do some more tricks?
Some more
magic.
Yeah, 100%. Like this time, I'm going to do something totally different with you. And it's the first thing when I was a magician and I wanted to do. The first time, like, I believed that I could be a magician and I had a dream of teleportation.
Okay.
So that's the basic dream of every magician.
He's just getting me scared with all these names and I like searching on digital and teleporting.
So basically, I'm gonna do some teleportation magic. So I was not able to learn how to teleport, but actually I learned how to teleport the cards.
You can teleport me out. I forgot my barbecue kit at home. I want to bring and come.
I would have teleported myself to so many places till now.
Yeah, man.
You would imagine it.
Barbecue kit, I forgot.
So the only thing we are gonna care about this magic is not the number, not the size of the cards, but the only count of the cards.
Okay.
The only count of the cards. So like I'm gonna count down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 cards.
Barabar.
I know you won't believe. What you have to just imagine is the cardboard of the card. So what we are gonna do is, right, we're gonna take this all the 10 cards. You don't think that I'm something suspicious or something?
No. You just do this card, Baba. I'm getting very tension.
Okay, but yeah. You didn't ask me to count the cards. You can count. See, it's one. Right? It's two. Right? Count it. Count it in front of everyone. Three.
Four. Five. Six.
Why your hands are shivering?
Seven.
Eight. Nine. Ten. Square it up and keep it inside your pocket. And if you don't mind, to hold it over here. Okay, that's great. Now, you can see that all the cards over here are totally random again over here. And this time, I'm going to ask you to just tell me stop. Is it okay for you?
Yeah.
You sure?
My heart is beating, man.
Yeah. That is what you have to feel, your heart beating. So, you have to just tell me stop wherever you want. It's totally upon you. Just say me stop.
Stop.
Over here, no cheating.
No.
You told me stop over here. Just go on and see the card.
Yeah, I see it.
So, we don't care about the suits and all. We just care about the number.
Okay, only number. Okay.
Yeah, the only number. So, if you can just say me loudly the number.
3.
It's 3. Okay, that's great. So, it's upon you. You chose 3, right?
I didn't choose it. You showed me the card. I just said it.
You told me stop,
right?
So, it was totally random. So, if it's the choice, I have to take out 3 cards from here and transfer it inside your pocket. I could do it like this. But that won't be magic anymore. So what I can do is basically, I have to do it by teleporting. So imagine you have 10 cards and 3 cards. If I put it over there, it becomes 30. So just take a try. It's the first card. Did you felt it?
Yeah.
You felt it?
Yeah, I felt it.
Okay. That's the first card transferred and that's the second card. You felt it bigger? Okay, and that's the third card.
Hey! Now,
what do you think, right?
I know that, I want to know there are 10 cards, but I know somewhere how he's done something and 13 cards are there.
See, what you have to do is, you have to just take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, you have to count the cards down.
No more?
Yeah, loudly, one by one, very carefully.
1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Wait, that's the 10 cards and more.
11, 12, and 13.
But if I ask you to just square it up again and push it inside your pocket again and hold it tightly. And if I ask you to give me any number between, which number would you like to, between 1 to 10, first.
4.
right? And if I ask anyone over here to you random, four you are carrying, yeah, any number between 1 to 5 loudly. 3. So we have two numbers, no cheating, no cheating. So you are giving me a number 4,
yeah,
and you are giving me a number 3. That sounds to
7.
7. Just keep it tight over here. Just keep it tight over here. 7. So that's a totally random number. I have not forced you. Like you choose a number 4 and you choose a number 3. But you both chose a number that sums up to 7 and you have 13 cards now inside your pocket.
Huh.
13 cards inside your pocket.
They increase, man.
They increase, you felt it?
Yeah.
No, they will increase right now. See how they will increase. 13 cards inside your pocket. Keep it tight. Keep it tight over here. 13 cards inside your pocket. 4 you choose, 3 you choose. Sums up to 7. 13 plus 7, that will equal to exactly 20 cards. You won't believe me? Do one thing. Just count it loud over here. Loudly. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20.
I don't know what to say. I could literally feel the card like increasing. I don't know how. But great magic, Jerry. And is there some trick you would like to teach us? But before you teach us a trick, before you teach us a magic, is there some advice you would like to give people who are, who must have not found somebody like me, where you took a call of taking magic as a career?
Like,
but how you give these people an advice that take magic as a career, or may not be only magic, maybe anything? Like how you decided you want to do something different.
So I would actually tell all the people only this much that see, struggle is there in every field. Even if you are doing a job or even if you are an artist. See, I do believe.
Even if you are a priest, there is a lot of struggle.
Yeah, but I do believe, yes, being an artist have a quite more struggle. But trust me, you are going to get the advantages of that as well, right? So
you're just trying to say that if you have passion and if you have dedication, just go for it.
Go for it.
Yeah.
You will love to do it.
Yeah. So all those who are willing to becoming a priest, please contact Father Aniceto and y'all can join this year.
That's great.
And all those who want to become magicians, please follow me on Instagram. I will tell you the next steps ahead. So come on, Jerry. Now what we want is, we were blown away with your magic and tricks. Now we want to learn something. Now you have to teach us one magic before we
I can teach you one magic, like if you have a note or something.
Arre, I don't know.
No, but maybe you have it inside your ear right over here. So I can actually take it out. That is totally okay for me.
Shekazar.
Okay. So if you can focus. No, that's not possible.
Thank you.
So if you can just focus on the Gandhiji over here or the placement of the note. So it's not inverted right now. So but what in case if you fold it on the top side over here. And I'm not going to do any goofy things, right?
Okay.
So it's like that only. You can see it's not inverted till now. So I'm not going to do anything. I'm going to just do it one fold and the second fold. And I'm not going to just snap.
Yeah.
Not going to do anything but just snap. Yeah. And when I open it, you can see that it gets inverted like that. It's so simple.
I thought you were going to do a trick where Gandhiji's head will get hair. And I was supposed to be tried on me.
If I do that, it won't be valuable anymore.
No. But can you teach us how to do this?
So it is very simple. If you take a note like this and if you fold it on the upward side, nothing is going to happen. But when you fold it from right to left, it's from right to left.
Everyone, please practice this. Right to left.
So just imagine you're folding it from right to left and you have to create an illusion. For a while, ye note se dhyan hatana hai sab logon ka, and you have to fold it like this.
Okay.
No, that's just a joke.
No, shit. I thought that's what you did.
No. So, you have to do nothing. Just when you take it from right to left, you have to open it from left to right.
Oh.
That's it. So, the moment you open it from left to right, it gets inverted like this. And you can fool your mom and dad and, you know, just, it's a party trick. You can enjoy it anywhere else.
So, do a trick on, other tricks, take 2000 rupees note and put in a pocket and convert to 100 rupees note. That's also a trick you, cannot teach. That you didn't teach me. I'll take people's.
But I used to do it in my show. So that is totally okay.
Oh my God. So everyone, please give Jerry a round of applause. He's been such a great, segment to get a magician. And thank you, Deacon Ivan, for inviting Jerry. And Thank you, Jerry, for coming.
Thank you so much, Melroy, for inviting me on Date with Devi.
That's a great thing that you say about me. We hope that you please keep coming here.
100%
and we want to
sure.
please invite you again and again and again 100%. And again. And every time we'll invite you, we will ask you to do one trick. So by the 100th time, I'll also do 100 tricks and I can go out and do some shows.
Only if we change the word from trick to magic.
No, or magic, damn it. 100 magics, and then I will also be a magician, and Ivan, I'll go on the show and, we'll both go together and earn money. Let's go and earn some money. So thank you so much.
If you really enjoyed seeing my magic and you love seeing magic, you can anytime go on Google, YouTube, or anywhere. You have to just type Jerry Magician. It's very simple. JERRYMAGICN. You can search it anywhere and you'll get my profile right in front of your eyes.
And we'll also be putting it down here somewhere. Yeah.
Wherever. Magic, it will change the position.
And at different positions. And we will... So thank you, Jerry, once again. And yes. Hope you had a wonderful evening this with Date with Devicey. Hope you had a wonderful time with us. And thank you. Until we see you next week once again with some more of entertainment and drama. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.
So, Jerry, thank you so much for coming. We have a small token of appreciation. This is cup that I'd like to give you. Okay. This is with a cool really Jesus nice. In this. And
cool Jesus.
Yeah. And this awesome. Is with a big token of appreciation from our
thank
end
you so
for
very
you.
Much.
Thank you so much for coming
thank
to
so
our event. And thank you so much, guys.
Thank you so much.
In the next episode...